morning, Sunday the 23rd of April 2017, and we're back in the studio live. Oh yes, after our wonderful little holiday up to north, we had a lovely holiday, boys and girls, as you well saw through the videos, didn't you? Yes, you did indeed. Well, good evening to the early people who are with us today. Joe is there, Norm is there, Rod's with us. Good evening, boys and girls. You're a little bit quiet tonight, a bit quiet on the quiet side this evening. I thought I'd do Sunday night, there'd be loads of... Oh, do you know what? I've just realised the cat's in the garden. Oh, I should have brought her in before I started the show. Oh, never mind, dear. She'll be all right. I'm sure she can see in the dark. Actually, I don't think she can see very well at all now. I still haven't yet made my appointment with the vet, actually, to do a little bit of a checkup for Katie. As you know, she's quite elderly now, boys and girls, and she needs all sorts of things looked after. I was cleaning her paws yesterday because she walks in her own mess, you know, cleaning the paws. What I do is I get a bucket of water. Actually, it's actually Ronnie that showed me this. I got a bucket of water and I put not a bucket of water, like a, what do you call them? Not buckets. You know those things you put in a sink? You know the sink basins. I've got an old sink basin. So I fill that with very tepid water with just a little bit of hand washing it, and I, you know, do it and make those little bubbles on that. And then what I do is I've got, because she's too old to fight back anymore. You know when cats don't like something, they tell you, don't you? Well, she's too old to do that now. So you can literally do anything you want to her, to be honest. And I get her carefully and I hold her like that and I put her paws in and she starts meow and it then starts splashing. And what I do is I hold her in such a way and I gently move her from side to side to agitate. Honest, to agitate her little front paws in the water. And then I leave it for a minute and then I do it again. I do it a couple of times and then I kind of get her... I don't sit on her, but I kind of put her between my legs. And I've got her paws like that and very, very gently... with a J cloth. You get a roll of J cloth. So I've got a roll of J cloths. And I get the J cloth and I gently do her paws. And the water goes quite... they can get very dirty in just one night. Honestly, you leave it for a couple of days and they're absolutely filthy. So what you have to do, and not a very nice smell, but this is one of those things. And I gently push her little paws, you know, the pads, so that the claws come out. And I remove the offending dirt from the paws. And then I do the other one. You would think it would be more difficult to do the back legs at first again. So now I've got her front bit and I move her to the front of the bowl. So her two clean front paws are now outside the bowl and the dirty back paws are now in the bowl. And again, she splashes about a little bit. When she realises she's not going to get anywhere, she soon calms down. And once again, I kind of wet them and then I have to get her out and put her sort of almost upside down to get her back paws. She's worse with her back paws. But after a while, she seems to actually realise, I think, that I'm trying to do her some good, you know. And she kind of lets you do it and you clean it and then that's it. And then for half an hour or so, I let her walk around the garden to dry them off. And I do, the last few days, actually, she's spent a lot of time in the garden. I think it's probably good for her to be in the garden, but we got some cold weather coming. So that might not be happening soon. Now, do I have my weather report, boys and girls? Let's have a look. Look at this. In this morning's, in today's Daily Mail, England basks in glorious sunshine as revellers celebrate St. George's Day. Did you celebrate St. George's Day? No, didn't celebrate St. George's Day. Doesn't happen, does it? Why is that? Why is that? I don't understand why St. George's Day doesn't happen. There was one bloke, one person today. I went to town this afternoon and there was one person there who had like a... I didn't see a St. George's cross anywhere, but he had like this white hat on with a red feather and a white feather. And that was kind of it. And he did look a bit strange. You know how certain people, you're probably looking at me and thinking I look a bit strange. You know there's certain people and then they got a strange, he did have a strange look. And he was the only one I saw there. Absolutely true. That he was the only one. Anyway, the weather report. Here comes the weather report. I'm sorry I'm not as good as some of the weather reporters on BBC News Channel. Oh, no. There's one on there who's quite nice. He's got a little bit of grey in his hair. Anyone know what his name is? He's about 30-ish. He's got a bit of grey in his hair. Oh, I can't think of his name now. I've never been too keen on Thomas. Bit smarmy. I think he's one of us, you know. I think Thomas is a bit like that. Anyway, back to today's weather fog. I don't have a weather map behind me, although I do have a new picture. Do you like that? Isn't that colourful? Look at that. Oh, it's... Hang on a minute. There we are. £20 off eBay. I was showing that yesterday, but you can see the whole thing now because the camera I was using, it was using a different camera for the... I use a different camera usually for the record... Well, sometimes for the recordings. So you didn't see it, but that's all of it. You can see all of it there. Oh, and the cat's behind me as well. Here, pussy, pussy. Nice little pussy cat. That's behind me. Let me just adjust something. I've forgotten to turn off the autofocus, I think, and that's going to annoy you if I don't turn it off. Just a minute now. there it goes. Save that and save that. That's better. That should be better for you. All right. Here comes today's weather forecast without weather map, I'm afraid. Without weather map. Yes. It says, thousands attended this year's St. George's Parade. Members of the parade were in high spirits, boys and girls. And there's bluebells everywhere. Have you noticed that? My garden is awash with colour at the moment. Awash with colour. Yes, it is. However, here comes the weather. There will be some cloud and rain in Scotland. Oh, that's today. This will slowly sink southwards. There might be some rain and cloud coming south throughout the night with some wintry showers in the north of the country. They might even have snow up north. And this isn't unusual, is it? Be honest. I was actually looking on my... on my weather app thing. And actually, the weather forecast, it's mainly at night time it's going to get very cold. And we're seeing temperatures of 13, what is that, 50-ish, 55-ish, sort of 13 degrees centigrade, 14 degrees centigrade during the daytime next week. But very low, like, night. So when I come home from work, it'd be like 2 degrees. I might even have to turn the heating back on again. Please, no. Anything but the heating. Oh, no. Once again, that gas bill is surging higher and higher. Love. That's what British Gas should use. You know, when they come on to do jingles for their company, fitting radiators and gas bills and all that, they should play that jingle. That song. Bill is going higher. The bill's going higher. It's so higher. Da, 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 da. And you thought Donald Trump was mad. He hasn't met me yet, dear. Don't worry about that. Anyway, so it's going to be a bit colder next week. But down in the south here, of course, we have permanent summer down here. It's just those people up north. Up north. Like my sister, she's up north. Permanent winter. Oh, my God. When I went up to visit her last week, I literally had to take a spade and one of those pickaxes, you know, those snow pickaxes that they use to climb up the mountain. Why do people do that? Why on earth would you want to be all cold and tired and climb up little old Mount Everest? Isn't there a lift? Why hasn't anyone built a lift or some sort of a moving walkway covered? You know, so that normal people like you and me can go up Mount Everest. Why does it have to be, oh, we're really butch. With those pickaxes and some of them fall off and die. What's all that about? Now, will someone please tell me the fun in climbing Mount Everest, which, you know, or going to Haven Holidays on one of their caravans. I know where I'd rather be, dear. Awful. They don't even have central heating in the tents. What's all that about? Madness. Absolute madness. I don't know. No idea why people want to climb Everest like that. Let's have some of your messages, shall we? I'm rabbiting on once again. One moment, please. Finding your messages. There we are. Hello to... we've done Joey, haven't we? Good evening to James Clark. Evening, James. Bit late, dear. Chop, chop, dear. Come along. Do keep up with the rest of us, lovey. Shania's with us. Good evening, Shania, on Izzly Widgets. Oh, yes. Norma says, I like the picture behind you. Yeah, it's lovely, Norma, isn't it? Only £20 off eBay. That's very good. 20 quid off eBay. It's not bad, is it, eh? 20 quid? Have a look. eBay. Just type in Prince. I think Prince or something like that. And there's another lovely one, actually, which is like under the sea. You know, shells and little coloured tropical fish ears and that sort. There's another one in there. And they're different prices for different sizes. That's actually quite a small one. I'll be honest with you. It's a bit smaller than I thought it was going to be. And what I should do every few weeks is have a new picture behind us. I thought, shall I buy a load at the same time? But then it starts getting expensive if you buy a load at the same time, doesn't it? So if I don't mind spending, you know, 20 or 30 quid every few weeks on a new picture behind me. I'll have to get another room built here to hold all the pictures, I think. Yes. Good afternoon to Blakey. Hello, Blakey. What's that? Why are you... You shouldn't put your number on there, darling. Call me at Chris... What do you mean, call you, dear? What do you mean, call you? Phone lines are not open yet, dear. I haven't opened it. Have you seen a light come on somewhere that says, please call in there? I've got far too much to say. I'm going to delete that because you've just given everyone your phone number, you fool. Anyone could ring up, dear. People could be giving you all sorts of offers. Good afternoon. Good evening to Adam. Evening, Adam. Now, Adam has got a new flat. But you haven't told me where it is, Adam. Why don't you let us know, Adam? We need to know, lovey. We need to know about your flat hunting and how badly it went and where you've ended up. Please, could you call in? Thank you. You know the number. So we would like to call in about the flat that you are now about to move into. That would be very, very interesting. Thank you very much, Adam. Okay, now let me see. What have I done there? Oh, I've done something wrong. Just a moment. What have I done wrong? Done something wrong. Yes, I'm looking at the wrong damn video here. That's what I've done. Oh, God. Was it that one? That'll do. There we are. Yes, Adam, we need to know. I think we need to know that. Where you've moved into. There we are. So if you could give us a little call in and then we can discuss that, OK? Very surprised no one noticed that we had the wrong date up yesterday. You didn't notice that. And I don't know why that happened. I thought it was the batteries because that clock there, there's like a battery for the clock. OK. And there's also separate batteries for the date. And they go and something flips over. It's all very clever and technological in here. But that's how that works. And for some reason, the date didn't click over yesterday. And no one noticed that, did you? Very surprised at young Jerry. Oh, Jerry says that we can now invite people to the conversation. I'm not quite sure how you do that, Jerry. That's very, very strange and mysterious, Jerry. Please, could you let us know how that happens? OK, right, we'll open the phone lines now. Just a moment, please. Oh, yeah. Phone lines are now open. If you want to call in at some point, lines are open. 020-8144-3477 is my local London number. 020-8144-3477. Oh, look at that. That's very quick. Adam the plumber is calling in on line 7,438. Good evening, line 7,438. Is that Adam the plumber? And are you on a reasonable phone where we will be able to hear you at good quality? Thank you.
Good afternoon, good evening, good morning, good afternoon, Mr. Chris Ridden, international DJ of several years.
Of several years. And I'm speaking to you, of course, from the United Kingdom Talk television complex here in Royal Berkshire.
Yes, indeed. The Great Mirabal Studios that are recognised worldwide.
They are recognised worldwide, I do believe
they're
so.
They're even on Google Maps.
Are we on Google Maps, darling? I didn't know that, lovey.
I'm sure you must be.
Oh, I'll have to do a little... Not that I'm wondering... Do you know, some people search for their own names. How sad is that? You can see sort of people like that lot on Towie. Oh, what about that business on Towie? You know that bloke who threw acid at a crowd, didn't they? Or something like that? What was his name?
Something stupid like that. Probably something to get the ratings up.
Was he actually in that programme or was it just that girl?
I have no idea. Wouldn't want dreadful that people. If he paid me.
Dreadful people. Every last one of them in that. That's the sort of people we've got on the telly now. There was another story somewhere this morning. I can't remember where it was now that I saw something like a reality show or something like that, you know, who had done something wrong. Anyway, I don't know. So, yes, Adam, you've got to move out of your little place in Dulwich, haven't you? Dulwich.
Yes, that's right. Yes, I'm moving on from Dulwich. And yes. I'm
And it's now not been easy, has it?
Moving to Sidcup.
Oh, Sidcup. So you've gone a little bit further out.
Yeah, Sidcup in Kent. That's where I'm going to.
Right. But it wasn't easy finding a place, was it?
No, I still haven't confirmed it as yet.
So you were sharing a place. And how much were you paying in Dulwich?
Dulwich was around about 875-ish.
875. And what did you have for that, Adam?
One bedroom.
It was a flat, was it?
Yeah, one bedroom flat.
Was that in a sort of a nice area or in a block or what?
It was in a nice sort of 1930s, 40s block. Very yes. Well kept, very well looked after. But in the 6 years that I've lived there, I've had the van broken into about 7 times.
Oh, I didn't know. I didn't know that. I thought it was a little bit better than that. Okay, carry on, dear.
Yeah, I mean, it is a nice area, but, you know, if people see a van, they want to break into it because I think there's something in it worth nicking.
Yeah, you don't leave anything in your van, do you?
No, not tools or anything. No, they all come out on my
Yeah,
my
most people
tools.
Do take the tools out. I do notice, you know, when they have those big juggernaut-type things, when mm-hmm. they're parked up, because you often see those parked up in lay-bys and places like that, and they leave the doors open, don't they?
Yeah, that's right, yeah, presumably so. Yeah. They can see there's nothing there worth nicking.
They leave the doors open, yeah. So how has your journey of looking for a place gone before you found the one that you found?
Well, it's quite a difficult journey these days because the rents are extortionately expensive. I mean, luckily, I got this flat where I'm hoping to go to. This is after they checked references and checked employment history and yes. checked everything except for your inside leg measurement. I mean, to give you an example, the first one I went and looked at was in a place called Catford.
Catford, yes.
Catford in southeast London. And it was a third floor on a main road. And I'm trying to think of the sizes. Now, in the pictures, it looked quite big and quite nice. But when you actually got up it, you got up to the third floor by more or less climbing this step ladder. Or it felt like it, even though there were sort of stairs, they were so steep, you more or less had to climb it like a step ladder.
Right.
So you got into the flat, and it was, I suppose, if you think of a two-seater sofa, that was along one wall, and then the front door next to it. And then if you were to lay down on the floor, your feet would touch the kitchen units on the other side.
Oh, and my word.
Then
did it look like it had been like one flat made into two?
No, I think it was just a very small attic made into a flat.
Ah, right, okay.
Then you went into the bedroom and the bed actually went under the roof line. So your feet were actually just above the roof line. If you can imagine the roof going down at an angle. Your feet would more or less touch the ceiling, if you like, of the roof.
Oh, my God.
And then, of course, you had the bathroom. Now, that was £800 per calendar month.
Right.
For
wow.
that. There was absolutely no parking. It was all permanent parking. It was a main road. The flat was in pretty bad dire condition. And to actually move in, with all the fees and everything else and everything on top, it just shy of £2,000.
Gosh.
So we knocked that one on the head. The next one we went to was in a place called Eltham.
You said is that you and someone else then?
No, me, just me. Sorry.
Okay, right,
the royal we. So the next place I went and looked at was on Eltham High Street.
Yes.
Now this one was on for £850 per calendar month. Fairly big flat, comprising of kitchen, lounge, bedroom, and separate bathroom.
Wow.
Now, I'm obviously, as you know, I do maintenance and building work, so I look at, I just look at the square, the room as a square. I tend not to notice if there's furniture in there or anything else like that. I just look at the actual shape and imagine where things yes. are going to be. So I'm looking around, and I've looked up on the ceiling. And at one point, they must have had a sunken spotlight fitted into the ceiling.
Right.
Now, obviously, the bulbs have gone on those, and what they've done is they've just put up ordinary 4-foot fluorescent fittings everywhere. So every room has got
fluorescent fittings in a house?
Yep, fluorescent fittings.
I can understand it in a kitchen, but that's about yep. all. How awful. Yep.
So that sort of put me off of it. I thought I can get around that, you know, I can change that for a spotlight or something at yep. some point. Anyway, for the entire duration of my stay there, All I could hear was thud, 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 thud. And I noticed there was a pram as I walked into the property.
Oh, no, dear, no.
So above me was a small child that was running constantly up and down the entire duration of the 20-minute
visit. Oh, deep joy. Deep joy. That would do me in noise. I'd have to move.
Mm-hmm.
I'd have to move for noise.
I'm thinking about this one. I'm thinking, okay, maybe, maybe not. You know, the child might calm down. Anyway,
I doubt that very much. Not for about 5 years.
Yeah. Anyway, it came to the magic figures. This time, £2,798.
And how was that broken down then?
It was £850 on the rent. 1 month's rent. Then 6 weeks deposit. So that was about 1,100 and something or other, if you do the maths on that.
Right.
And then the rest of it was made up of estate agent's fees, nearly £600, I think it was.
To do what?
Yeah, exactly.
Jeez. Exactly. They're trying to do something about that, aren't they?
They are. I mean, they really should ban it, you know. I mean, they should have a set fee of, I would say, more than enough would be £250.
I mean, we get that as well as landlords, you know. Hang on, in fact, let me get one of my little slips out just a moment, and I'll tell you.
All right.
Because I've just had a renewal. This is when it's a renewal. That's someone who they haven't moved out, but they've come to the end of their agreement.
Yep.
So they do another agreement. Now let me see if I can find it for you, dear. One moment, please. Let's have a look. It's not that one. I think it's this one. Here, 1 minute. Is this it? Here it is, right?
Mm-hmm.
Here we go. So this is someone, and they've been there a year already,
right? Yep.
Landlord's renewal fee. Okay, so So they have to pay something. This is what I have to pay. Landlord's renewal fee, £110. So what do you do for that? What do they do for
exactly.
that? They bring up a pre-made... contract. They bring up a pre-made contract. They push a print button, send it to them, send it to me. We both sign it. We send it back. £110. Mm-hmm. Shocking. Shocking. But you're saying your fees were like £600?
Something along those
That's
figures.
Horrendous.
Yeah.
Did you tell him? Did you tell him?
I said I'd get back to them, and when he's going to phone them, I'm going to say, your fees are too expensive, and I found somewhere. Thank you very much. Goodbye.
Good boy.
So that's what I'll be telling him. And the first one, actually, because I've got a cat as well, as some of you might know,
pussy, pussy, meow, meow. Yes.
Little Afro cat. And basically, for the first agency, he wanted an extra £100 for me to have the cat in the flat.
God.
So I don't know how they justify that.
Well, a month?
As part of the fee, you said additional £100 to book the cat in as well.
Not part of the deposit, no?
No, part of, extra on top of the deposit, yeah, an extra £100 on top of the
deposit. Oh, right, so you would get that back. Now, yes, if you have pets, some of them do add something on. I don't think I do. Sure I don't. Like, what happens if someone's got a pet or they're already in and they want a pet? They ring me up. Oh, so and so would like to know if it's okay for them to have a pet goldfish, you know, tortoise, tarantula, spider. I mean, what would you do? Okay, what would you do? You know, if I do wonder what I'd do. If someone said, "Oh, well, what a tarantula spider," maybe I'd probably say yes. And then they ring up. The bad news is it's escaped. Oh my God.
I mean, this is what really, really annoys me, Chris. I know you probably wouldn't have a problem with this, but this is what really annoys me with landlords, is they will not allow pets or animals into their
house. I do.
Why?
I do.
You're paying for their mortgage, basically. So why on earth would you not be allowed to bring pets in? I can understand, you know, if it's a large dog or something that might be, you know, not suitable in a flat.
A Great Dane or something like that, scratching away at your wall.
Yeah. You can understand that, but I mean, I was speaking to the landlord of one of these properties and like saying, you know, and they don't have a problem with pets. No, he said, but some of these landlords do. He said they won't even allow. In fact, the guy that I was waiting to see the flat that I'm going to go for, he was talking to me about it, and basically he was saying, that a friend of his wanted to take a turtle in a tank into a flat, and they wouldn't allow him to. You know,
well, that's not going to do anything, is it? A turtle, it just stays in the blooming tank.
In the tank. So, well, you know, and apparently he wasn't allowed to take it.
Well, I have to say, I think that would be a bit cruel, though, having a turtle. Yeah. I don't like things in tanks and cages, really.
No, I'm not. I mean, it's like when I transport Afro, he sits in the car with me. He doesn't go and carry cat.
Afro the cat. And they quite happily, they sit on the chair next to you, don't they? Quite happily. Or they just go to sleep. Cats just, they curl up and just go to sleep, don't they?
That's it. I don't know if you've got my picture up on screen at the moment.
I haven't. I can bring that up. One moment, please. With this modern technology, there is Adam the Plumber and Afro the Cat. Look at that. Look at that. It's practically BBC television colour here, isn't it? It really... Please don't laugh at that time. I'm very offended.
So that is Afro the Cat there looking up at me thinking, why are you doing this to me, Daddy?
Yes.
So, yeah. So that was that one. Property number 3 I went and saw. Again, a nice flat. And I sort of looked at it and it's like, okay, no gas central heating, just hung radiators. Those really nasty cheap panel heaters.
I know the ones, yeah.
The double glazing didn't really, they put double glazing on the front of the house and then sort of patched together this mix and match window at the back of the house, sort of made half out of a sash window and half made out of these two little tiny closing windows. And I thought, well, if there's ever a fire, I'm not going to get out of those things. You know, I might just get the cat out of one of them if I'm lucky.
It's quite funny. I'm having a sneezing fit here with a microphone off while you're chatting. Carry on.
Okay. So, yeah, it was a bit sort of okay. And it's funny, when I looked around the place, every door had a lock on it, a Yale lock on it. So I thought, oh, this has been a multiple occupancy at one point. You know, it's turning the flat into... a one-bedroom flat. He's obviously not had the permission to turn it into multiple occupancy. So I'm looking around and all the rest of it. I said, yeah, it's not bad, you know. What's the rent like? It was $850. I said, what's it? He said, now the electrics is an extra £110 a month.
Aye?
And the electrics and extra. So I said, so what you're telling me then is it's an illegal subdivision of flats then that have been made. He said, because your water rates, your electric is an extra £110 a month. And I'm like, even working that out the best in the summer, you would not spend £110 a month on your electric.
You wouldn't. That is shocking. What a rip-off. You're not even paying for the amount of electricity that you use.
No, exactly.
Dreadful. Ghastly people, dear.
So I was sort of debating about that one. And, you know, because by this time I've sort of seen all these terrible properties. And I'm thinking they're all in a shocking state, you know, and what have you. So I'm like, by this point, I'm like ready to sort of throw the towel in because I cannot find a property that's suitable.
And buy
for
a tent. You should buy a caravan, lovey. Buy a caravan.
Yeah, it would be easy and just took it on the back of the van.
Oh, we had travellers. We had travellers round here the other day and they had wired in their caravan to a street lamp. On my life.
They were what, sorry?
They wired a caravan into a street lamp. Travellers, we had that down the road.
That's quite common.
Is it quite common?
Yeah, I used to be a street lighting engineer for Brighton Council. And we used to get it all the time because you can run quite a lot of power off of a street lamp. You think it's not a lot of power, you know, to run them, but they do actually have quite a high amperage on them.
Yeah, but they're are they 240 volts then? I thought they were like 400 or 500.
No, they're 240 volts.
Oh, I didn't know that.
They are three phase because if you notice when you get a power cut sometimes, you'll notice half the street lights are still on. Because what happens is in electrics, you've got on higher voltage, you've got three phases. You've got red, yellow and blue phase. So what sometimes happens is down at the substation, the red phase will blow out. So you'll lose half the street, but half the street will still be on because the yellow and blue phase are still on.
Right.
If you follow me, you got three phases. So that's what happens with street lamps. You get a red one going to street lamp one, a blue one going to street lamp two, and a yellow one going to street lamp three. Well, it repeats the process.
The travellers had wired straight into the lamppost here.
Yeah.
I thought you would get electrocuted doing that, love. I'd be scared to get electrocuted.
No, they put what they do is they pull the fuse carrier out, unwire the lamp, unwire the actual column, and then wire in what they want to wire
do
in.
Do people do that in their houses as well?
We had a couple of cases in Brighton where we used to get reports of cables coming out of street columns, and we actually had one where it went into a house. It was actually an extension lead run into the house to run cannabis to run a cannabis factory or whatever.
Oh yeah, that'd be right. Yeah,
to run the lighting for that.
Because have all these special lights and fans and things, don't they, for those?
That's right,
business, yeah.
The police can normally tell because it gives off an extraordinary
amount
of heat.
Smell coming. I've had that before, smelling stuff coming out of places.
Yeah, I can believe it. It's quite common. There's a lot of money in
it. So, listen, you've got your place in Sidcup. How much is this one?
This one is £750 per calendar month.
Ah, excellent.
With only a 4-week deposit of £750.
Right.
And an agency fee of £250.
Is this because you've gone out of London?
I don't know, because Sidcup isn't that far, even though it's classed as Kent.
Right.
It is actually just on the outskirts of southeast London. It's near Eltham, Sydenham, sort of around that area there, so it wouldn't take you too long to get in. I mean, literally, the railway station is at the bottom of the road.
Right,
so I believe there's direct services into London Bridge or Cannon Street or somewhere like that.
Oh, dear, yeah.
It takes very little time. But, you see, because I've got the car and the van, it's a lot easier for me to move around, sort of thing.
You got two spaces outside there, or do you have to buy one of those...
It's a funny parking permit situation there, actually. I haven't quite worked it out yet, because the permits in that road operate between 1 o'clock and 3 o'clock in the afternoon. So it's a bit strange and mysterious how that works. I'm not quite sure yet. I'll have to work that one out. It's between 1 p.m. and 3 p.m, presumably to stop commuters from parking their cars while they go off to... I think a lot of places do that near railway stations. They sort of have these weird and wacky times that only operate for 2 hours a day. If you know what I mean. Oh, are we still there, Chris? Hello?
Oh, sorry, dear. Yeah, I'm sniffing. I think I might have to stop doing the show today. I'm sniffing and sneezing away here for some reason, and I can't keep talking without having to have a good sniff and pushing my mute button so people can't hear me like this.
Ah, is that what it is?
It was all right earlier. It was fine earlier. I don't know what's gone wrong. I get this business with my throat now and again, but never mind. We're still here.
We shall carry on like the BBC do.
Well, I'm very glad you found a place. Congratulations, Adam.
Yes, and the BBC does stand for the British Broadcasting Chrisorisation.
You mad fool. When do you move in?
This is it. This is the next stage now. We found the place. Now we've got to get past all the credit checks and the reference checks.
But that'd be all right, wouldn't it? You haven't been murdering people or stealing from banks or anything, have you?
Not that I'm aware of, no. No, I've got a clean health bill and all that rubbish. So
right, okay.
I would hope. But it's always a worry. It's stressful.
Yeah, I should think it is.
I'll be happy. And as I say, the place I've got is a top floor, one bedroom.
Good.
With a balcony, kitchen, bathroom, toilet, bedroom and lounge.
Good.
Needs a bit of painting, but to be honest with you, that's the way I like them. And I can put my own stamp
Good.
On it.
You can do your own little thing there. Lovely to talk to you, Adam, and congratulations.
Cheers. Speak to you soon.
Au revoir. Bye-bye now.
Au revoir. Bye-bye.
There we are. Adam the plumber. Oh, good. I'm glad he sorted that, because he has been looking for a place for sort of a reasonable period of time. And it's a lot, and it's so dear to move to places. Now, I've got a place up north. It's a two-bedroomed house with garage, not attached to it, like garage in a block, and a garden. Do you know that goes out for £475 a month? Honest, and it's reasonable, and it backs onto field. This place actually backs onto field. So you've got the little house, which is like a terrace. There's quite a few of them along. I'm on the end. So you've got the house, and then you've got a little garden at the back, and then it backs on just onto fields. Beautiful. £425 a month. What will you get? You won't get nothing in London for that. £900 a month for some grotty old room. You know, dealt with by a nasty landlord as well. What a shame. Just awful, awful. Let's do some of your messages, boys and girls. Hello to Kevin Webster. Kevin Webster's with us this evening. Evening, Kevin. And Elaine in Israel is with us as well. Good evening, Elaine. Nice to see your little face appearing. Appearing there, and as always, thank you very much for those people who are, have bothered to share our little show on their walls as well. So there's something going wrong with these messages this evening. I'm not kind of getting these straight up for some reason. I don't know why that is. Right. So what did I do today? I watched Doctor Who. I tell you, that's excellent. Anyone watching Doctor Who at the moment? It's really good. It's coming on very, very well. And there were some very, very funny lines in there last night. One, the doctor was saying, they were talking, him and his, what do they call, the assistant, the doctor's assistant. They were talking about planets. And he said, oh, there's a Scottish group on that planet. And he said, that's the trouble with the Scots. Always want independence. Doesn't matter what planet they're on. So I thought that was quite good. So excellent series of Doctor Who happening at the moment. Then I went to town and I had to drop off a couple of parcels. Now, when I went on holiday, I meant to take my nephew Jimmy's birthday present up, but I forgot, completely forgot that he was OK with that. So I sent that off this afternoon. DHL, the international network, although they're not international, I'm just sending out up north. So I sent his present up, and also my accounts. my tax year runs April to March. So I've been getting together all the bits of paper, all the receipts, all the invoices, everything like that, all the bank statements and everything like that. I put it all in a big bag, take it down to Ryman's, actually. It's normally Ryman's where they do the send off the DHL stuff. So I took it down to Ryman's. You get like different sizes of boxes. I don't know if I've got the actual leaflet here. Is the leaflet here? No, it's not here. But they've got different sizes of boxes, and your item has to go in one of the boxes. And if it goes in the box, that's it. You get the price. There's none of this weighing lark business that you get in the post office. Got to measure this and weigh this. Oh, it's so complicated and expensive in the post office. In DHL, as long as it goes in this box, then off it goes. And that's brilliant. Brilliant. I think I spent about £36 sending all my accounts to Scotland, my accountants in Scotland, and sending off my nephew's birthday present. So that's what I did this afternoon. Done a lot of gardening today as well. I've been training stuff up my fence. The fence at the side, I put in some climbing plants last year. Now they're starting to go up now. So I've got a stapled around there and did that sort of thing. All right. Now, I'm going to have to cut the show short, because I've got this blooming guitar that keeps coming up, and it's really quite difficult to keep talking if that's happening all the time. So I'm going to disappear now, boys and girls. I'll just do today's birthdays. I would have stayed a lot longer, but I can't today. All right, let's do today's birthdays, boys and girls, and then we'll disappear. Happy birthday today to Stewart James Tiberius Franco. Now, that's a name and a half, isn't it? Oh, dear, what a long name. Can I just call you Stu? Is that taking the mic to just call you Stu? Happy birthday, Stuart. Happy birthday to Fraser Renton. Long time no see, Fraser. Fraser and I worked together many, many times. He was part of a drag act. He's fantastic, Fraser. Very talented. Happy birthday, Fraser. Chris Halton is 43 today. Happy birthday, lovely Chris. Anthony Morgan says, be proud, it's St. George's Day. Happy birthday, Anthony. James Watts, happy birthday to James. Paul Schofield today is 49 years old today. Sam Lupton, I remember you from CMP Radio. Happy birthday, Sam. Hasn't the time gone? What's happened to the time? Rob Tyler, shake up your weekday shoes. It's time to get your sneakers on. 51 today. Happy birthday, Rob. And happy birthday today to Katarina Kikta. Katarina Kikta. I hope I got your name right there, my darling. Let me sing for you, and then I'm going to disappear and rest my throat tonight. Here we go. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, Happy birthday. Happy birthday to you. All right. Oh, Jimmy's there. Jimmy, your birthday present is on its way. It should be there Tuesday, sometime Tuesday, coming from DHL, the international network. All right, Jimmy. Anyway, I'm really, really sorry to have to leave you. You know I like to do a little bit long. I mean, I'm not as short as this. God, dear, not as short as this. But I do like to do a little bit of a longer show than I have done today. But I keep sniffing. And right at this moment, like, there's a gathering at the back, right at the back of my throat. And the only way I can clear it is to do this. And you can't hear that because I push a button. But it's okay if it's, you know, not too bad. But it keeps happening tonight. So I'll have to leave it there because it's getting difficult to talk to you, okay? Enjoy the rest of your Sunday night. I'll probably be back with you sometime tomorrow morning. I think I'll probably be back with you tomorrow morning. I can't go swimming this week, unfortunately, because the swimming pool, the sports centre that I go to, I say sports centre, it's part of the Hilton Hotel Living Well. They're all being done out, new machines and all that in the gym. I don't think they're doing anything to the swimming pool, but it's part of the same sort of thing. So we can't use the swimming pool for a whole week. So I've got a little bit more time on my hands. I think I'll probably go for a walk tomorrow over the forest at some point. But it's going to be cold, very cold. So do be careful of the cold weather. OK, thank you very much for watching and listening. I'll see you sometime tomorrow. Enjoy your Sunday evening. Bye-bye now.